Good morning, everyone. Now, first, quickly have a look what we have discussed in the last class. Suppose we have taken a liquid that is having plain meniscus. Okay, so if it is having plain meniscus, then force of surface tension, one along the tangent, see this is one of the tangent along the surface, and this is another force of surface tension. So both are equal and opposite. Resultant force of surface tension on this is zero, so there is no excess pressure for the plane surface. But for the concave meniscus, what we have done, like when we draw the tangents, like one tangent over here, one tangent over here, these tangents represent force of surface tension. So resultant force of surface tension will be in upward direction. So to maintain the shape of this concave meniscus, there must be excess pressure from the vapor side. Okay, because this is atmosphere, we can say this is the vapor side, this is the liquid side. So vapor pressure PV should be more than the liquid pressure, only then this shape can be maintained. So this is what we discussed in the last class, that here PV should be more than PL to maintain the shape of concave meniscus. Now for convex meniscus, when we have taken like these are the force of surface tension, tangent to the surface, and resultant force will act in downward direction. Now to maintain the shape of this meniscus, pressure on the liquid side, that is PL, should be greater than pressure on the vapor side. Now this is pressure on the vapor side. So here to maintain the shape, because force is acting in downward direction, so to maintain the shape, this pressure on liquid side must be greater than pressure on the vapor side for convex surface, for the convex meniscus. Okay, it means whenever there is curved surface, there is always excess pressure on either side, maybe on vapor side or on liquid side. So next, what article we have to discuss is excess pressure inside a liquid drop, excess pressure inside an air bubble, and excess pressure inside a soap bubble. So all the articles will go on same line. We will start with excess pressure inside the liquid drop. So the topic heading is excess pressure, and you will solve along with me side by side excess pressure inside the liquid drop. Now when we calculate excess pressure inside the liquid drop as well as inside the air bubble, both expressions are same. So both the articles will go on same line. I will solve with liquid drop. You will send me WhatsApp of excess pressure inside an air bubble. Now, what do you mean by excess pressure? Like here, we consider a liquid drop, spherical liquid drop, obviously, because sphere has minimum surface area. So we consider a liquid drop. Now, this is spherical liquid drop. So it is having excess pressure inside it because of its curved surface. It is having excess pressure. Suppose initially its radius is r. Due to excess pressure inside this, there will be excess pressure in all the direction acting perpendicular to the surface. So due to this excess pressure P, suppose the drop expanded its radius by delta r. Now let us consider the radius has been expanded by delta r. Okay, this is expanding the radius. We have to calculate this excess pressure P. Okay, so to calculate excess pressure, first we will see here, we have to use the formula for surface energy, that concept we will use here. So for that we need to first calculate what is the increase in surface area of this liquid drop. Initially, its radius was R, capital R. So, its initial surface area was, like surface area of sphere is 4 pi R square. So, initial surface area is 4 pi R square. Now, finally, its radius is R plus delta R. So, final surface area will be 4 pi into R plus delta R whole square. Now, let us see how it works. Like, increase in surface area. So, when you calculate due to that excess pressure, what is the increase in surface area? How can we calculate increase in surface area? This is final surface area minus initial surface area. Now you can put both the values, final and initial, because the radius has changed. Initially the radius was r, now the radius is r plus delta r. So when you put both the values, final surface area is 4 pi r plus delta r whole square minus initial surface area was 4 pi r square. Now here, when you open the bracket, it is 4 pi r square plus delta r whole square plus 2 r delta r minus 4 pi r square. Now open the bracket. So you will get 4 pi r square plus 4 pi delta r square plus 8 pi r delta r minus 4 pi r square. You can also solve. This is all mathematical. Simple mathematics is there. So when you will solve it, see this get cancelled. Now coming to this term, delta r is very small. The expand in radius, the increase in radius, that is very very small. So we can here neglect this delta r square because this will be further small. Suppose if it is 0.01, when you take the square, then it will be 0.0001. That is very very small. So we can neglect this term. Neglecting this term means we let us consider as compared to this, this term can be neglected. We can take it as 0. So we will get increase in area, surface area will be 8 pi r delta r. This is increase in surface area. Now we know what is surface energy, formula for surface energy. Yes, we have calculated for surface energy. The formula is work done over increase in area, surface area. So this is work done over increase in surface area. Now here, surface energy numerically it is equal to surface tension. Now let us consider if S is the surface tension of this liquid, then we can write here surface energy that is equal to S. It will be equals to work done over increase in surface area. Now you have calculated increase in surface area, that is 8 pi r delta r. So here increase in surface area is 8 pi r delta r. Okay, so from here work done will be equals to, so we are calculating work done, ultimately we have to calculate excess pressure. So first we calculate work done. Work done will be S into 8 pi r delta r. This is the work done. Now what is the another way to calculate the work done? So formula to calculate the work done. So we know what is the formula. Simple formula for work done, that is force into distance. So here we calculate the work done by applying the formula. See here surface energy, I think this is not visible to you. This is work done over increase in surface area. Then I have just put the value, I will solve it there also. From here I am continuing again. Surface energy is work done over increase in surface area. So when you have calculated surface energy numerically, that is equal to surface tension S. This is equal to work done. Work done as it is divided by increase in area. So what is increase in surface area? That is 8 pi r delta r. So this is increase in surface area. So from here work done is equal to S into 8 pi r delta r. So this is your work done. Okay, now what is the formula for work done? Work done is force into distance in the direction of force. Now here due to this pressure, force will be due to this excess pressure. Force is acting outwards, distance is also outwards because radius is expanding by delta r in outward direction. So force and distance, they are in same direction. So work done ke liye you can apply simple formula, force into distance. Now distance is delta r because radius has expanded from r to r plus delta r. So this is the distance traveled due to this excessive pressure, due to the force of this of excessive pressure. So we can write work done as F into delta R. This is 8 pi R delta R into S. Now from here delta R, delta R get cancelled. Further, we can write force as pressure into area. Force can be written like this. Pressure into area. Now here which area is taken? Surface area of the sphere. So force will be pressure into area. This is equal to 8 pi R into S. Area will be 4 pi R square, because this is the area on which pressure is acting. Initial area 4 pi R square. So P into 4 pi R square, that is 8 pi R S. Pi and pi get cancelled. Then do the cutting, necessary cutting. And then you will get pressure as 2 S divided by R. This is the formula for excess pressure inside a liquid drop. P is 2S over R, where S is surface tension, R is the radius of the liquid drop. Once again, I am repeating what we have done. We have to calculate excess pressure inside the liquid drop. That excess pressure is because of its curved surface. Due to that excess pressure, the radius has been expanded to R plus delta R. So first we have calculated what is increase in surface area by subtracting final surface area minus initial surface area. So we have done this. After solving it, we got 8 pi r delta r. Yahan pe humne delta r square, this term has been neglected. After that, we know surface energy is work done over increase in surface area. So we have used that formula, because surface energy numerically it is equal to surface tension. So surface tension is work done over 8 pi r delta r. So work done will be surface tension multiplied by this. Now afterwards you have to write what is work done. Work done is force into distance. Now force is due to this pressure. So that is why force is pressure into area. And distance traveled is delta r, because this much is the expansion. So here we have written pressure into area into delta r. Delta r, delta r get cancelled. So pressure into area, area is surface area, so we have substituted that value, and when you do the cutting, then pressure comes out to be 2s over r. This is excess pressure inside the liquid drop. Same as if the question comes, find the excess pressure inside an air bubble. Then instead of liquid drop, you will use the word air bubble. That excess pressure inside the air bubble, on the same line, same derivation, nothing will change. So you will do that expression also, and you will send me the WhatsApp. After that, next article is rapid changes aayenge, that is pressure inside a soap bubble. Excess pressure inside a soap bubble. Now I am not erasing all this, because I will do changes in this and will show you how the changes will occur. In the soap bubble, what is the difference between liquid bubble, liquid drop and the soap bubble, or the air bubble and the soap bubble? What is the difference? In soap bubble, actually there are two surfaces. There is air inside the soap bubble. You all must have seen soap bubble. You must have played with the soap bubbles in your childhood. So soap bubbles has two free surfaces. Air is inside the soap bubble as well as it is outside the soap bubbles. So it has two free surfaces. So whenever there is increase in surface area, it will be double. In case of air drop or air bubble or liquid drop, it is single. But in case of soap bubble, it will be double, because it has two free surfaces. So here increase in surface area, it will be two times final surface area minus initial surface area, because it has two free surfaces. So wherever you have written same calculations, final minus initial, uspe bhi radius will increase by delta r. So increase in surface area will be, you will multiply this by 2. So ultimately what will be the answer? Or simply jo answer usko 2 se multiply kar do. So 2 into 8, that is 16. So increase in surface area is 16 pi r delta r. Now again we will write surface energy is work done over increase in surface area. Now work done over increase in surface area. Here increase in surface area is 16. Instead of 8, here the word 16. 16 pi r delta r. Now work done, again we have to use the same concept, like work done will be s into 16. Now work done, now what is work done? Work done is again force into distance. Now although it has two free surfaces, but the distance traveled is only delta r. By both the surfaces, they both traveled the distance delta r only. So here f into delta r, then force can be written as pressure into area. On the right hand side, instead of it, just write 16, because here 16 is the 16 pi r delta r into s. Delta r get cancelled. So pressure into area is this. Now area, initial surface area is 4 pi r square, जिसके ऊपर आपका pressure लग रहा है force के लिए. So here pressure will be, here you will get 16 pi r into s, and here area is this. When you will do the cutting, then it is 4 pi 1 r get cancelled. So the answer is excess pressure comes out to be 4 s over r. So actually it is double of air bubble or liquid drop. Once again, for the soap bubble has two free surfaces because it is having air inside also as well as outside. So its increase in surface area will be double because it has two free surfaces. So this is increase in surface area. Then surface energy, we know it is work done over increase in surface area. Thus work done over this. Then work done we can calculate by force into distance. So this is the formula for the pressure, excess pressure inside the soap bubble, that is 4s over r. Okay, so this is the topic for finding the excess pressure inside the liquid drop, inside an air bubble or inside the soap bubble, and this excess pressure is because of their curvature, because of their curve. Now the thing is, like, the curve, some curves are concave, some are convex. So we can have an idea about the meniscus from a quantity called angle of contact. Okay, so next our topic is angle of contact. We will just discuss this angle of contact, because we have already done with meniscus and all, concave meniscus and convex meniscus. So I'll start with the same, like, again we'll consider three different types of meniscus. One is plane. Now this is the plane meniscus. Okay, one meniscus is your concave. One of the type is concave. Okay, suppose this is the concave meniscus. And the third type is convex. That is, for example, mercury. So this is your convex meniscus. Now what is angle of contact? Angle of contact, I will draw here two tangents first. Suppose if this is the surface, I will draw at the point of contact, I will draw two tangents. One is to the liquid surface and one tangent to the solid surface. Now this is the solid surface. Tangent can be in upward direction, tangent can be in downward direction. But we always have to draw the tangent for the solid surface which is in contact with the liquid. Like here, this solid surface is in contact with the liquid, so the tangent will be in downward direction. Then the angle between these two tangents, that is called angle of contact. Now here, this is the tangent to the liquid surface, this is tangent to the solid surface inside the liquid. So the angle between these two, that is called angle of contact, and here you can see clearly the angle of contact is 90 degrees. So for a plane meniscus, angle of contact is always 90 degrees. Now let us see what is angle of contact for concave meniscus. Now this is your concave meniscus. First I will draw a tangent. Why in downward direction? Because liquid is present here in downward direction. So this is tangent to the liquid meniscus, this is tangent to the solid surface, or we can say this is the tangent to the liquid, this is tangent to the solid surface. Now this is the angle. Now is it acute or obtuse? So it is acute, means whenever there is concave meniscus, angle of contact is always acute. Now coming to convex meniscus. Now when you draw a tangent, now one tangent will be to the solid surface, the tangent will be over here. And to the liquid surface, the tangent will be like this, because it is going upward. So this is the angle of contact, theta. Now clearly you can see which type of angle is this. This is obtuse. So here, whenever angle of contact is obtuse, it means convex meniscus is formed. So it can be in either way. Like suppose angle of contact is given to you. Suppose angle of contact is 120 degree. So what type of meniscus will be there? Concave or convex? So obviously it will be convex because it is obtuse angle. Similarly, suppose if angle of contact is given to you 30 degree. So which type of meniscus is formed here? Concave, because this is acute. And if angle of meniscus means angle of contact is 90 degree, then obviously plane meniscus is formed. Plane meniscus is formed when you take water inside a silver container, inside a silver glass, or you take water inside wax, a glass coated with wax. Glass coated with wax, that will make convex. When you will take glass inside the silver, that will make an angle 90 degree. And in that case, of course, that liquid will wet the container, because glass wet the silver container. But if the angle of contact is obtuse, then the liquid will not wet the container. For example, mercury. So it always forms obtuse angle, so it will not wet the container in which we pour the mercury. For example, if you pour water inside a container that is coated with wax, water will not wet that container. So it will always form convex meniscus in that. So even water can form convex meniscus if it will not wet that container. Means in that case, angle of contact is obtuse. And if angle of contact is acute, then obviously the liquid will wet the container because it is having concave meniscus. So always remember, if the liquid is having concave meniscus, if it is having acute angle of contact, then it will wet the container in whatever container you pour it. But if it is making obtuse angle, then it will not wet the container. Okay, so what is angle of contact? Once again, I am saying, what is angle of contact? The angle between the tangents drawn to the liquid surface and the tangent drawn to the solid surface lying inside the liquid or in contact with the liquid, that angle is called angle of contact. It can be acute, obtuse or plane. Okay, and angle of contact depend upon certain factors. For example, it depend upon the nature of solid and liquid in contact. Like water can make acute as well as obtuse angle of contact. It all depend upon the nature of surface, nature of container in which we have taken water. Okay, so it depend upon the nature of surfaces in contact. Then it depend upon the cleanliness of the surface. How clean is the surface? It depend upon those factors also. Okay, so after that, it depend upon the medium. Like above liquid, which kind of medium is there? If there is excess pressure, then of course the meniscus will be concave. So it depend upon the medium above the surface of water. And then it depend upon the temperature of the liquid. What is the temperature? So accordingly, angle of contact will change. So it depend upon certain factors, nature of the liquid and surface in contact, medium above the liquid level, it depend upon the cleanliness of the surface, and it depend upon the temperature of the liquid. Okay, and angle of contact, obviously it is measured in degrees. So this is all about today. So today's work is, you have to do that article to find pressure inside an air bubble, and you have to send me through WhatsApp. Okay, that is all for today. And one thing more, you all will find out some more example of acute, the angle of contact that is obtuse. You have to find example of liquids, certain liquids which always make obtuse angle. You can give different examples. I need at least 3 or 4 examples for each case, for each angle of contact. For 90 degree, give me 4 examples. For acute angle, give me 4 examples, and for obtuse also. So this is your work for today. Thank you and have a nice day.